All right. We're letting the punters in as the punters fold in. Cheers to a fantastic TMF week. Thank you for joining us for the last session. Thank you, Rob, cleaning your glasses there.
Got to keep everything spick and span.
I seem to be hearing myself there. I'll turn that off. All right, we've got some folks coming in. For those of you that have just joined, there is a digital scorecard down at the bottom of the session below the description. It's an Excel spreadsheet. It's what you guys are going to keep score with today. So make sure you go and download that. There are two main sections to that document. Each round is listed there. And you need to make sure that you're capturing what your answer is or what you think the correct answer is. And then at the end of each round, we're going to go through and give you the correct answer so that you can mark down what your score is. I'm joined by our lad, Rob, who's the co-landlord at the Too Much Fun Bar. How you doing, Rob?
Yeah. All good. And Paul was asking where the sheep is. I've got the sheep dog. He's brought all the sheep in for the night. So, we're all ready to just have a bit of a good time now.
So I guess Paul thinks that we look more like shepherds and sheep herders than we do pub landlords.
I'm taking that's the case, yeah. Yeah, but, I would try and defend myself, but, you know, even having the sheep dog, it really doesn't bode well for me.
That's it. Or someone maybe could say Peaky Blinders. If anyone's a Peaky Blinders fan, so who knows? All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for joining us for the Trial Master File Trivia Pub Quiz, which is the last session of TMF Week. We have had an absolutely incredible time throughout the entire week. Some amazing, amazing sessions that have been held throughout the week. We've had great panels. We've had phenomenal presentations and sessions. We've had good product showcases. I've had a ton of fun in the lounge area, as I know you have, Bob. So I just want to thank everybody for being a part of TMF Week. It's been so great hosting you guys for another year, and we're excited to come back next year. My name is Oliver Pierce. I'm the Director of Commercialization, although I am a geezer for today's show. And then I'm joined by Rob Jones, or our lad Rob, who's a principal business consultant at Archivum. So just to give everybody a bit of an understanding of how today is going to work, we're going to be here for roughly an hour. If we finish before, perfect. We can have a few early beers. If we go a little longer, we can still have some beer. We have five multiple choice themed quiz rounds today. The rounds range from 5 to 10 questions per round. All of the questions are asked. We will go through that round, and then you should keep your answers in the digital scorecard. If you can't find the digital scorecard, we have some Montreal folks on the line that will be able to direct you to it. It is below the description. So if you scroll down a little bit while you're watching us, you scroll down, there's a little file that says digital scorecard. That scorecard is going to give you the ability to put your answers, the answers that you think are right, as we go through this quiz. And when we go through the correct answers, you'll be able to mark which answers are correct and if you've got them right or not, and then the spreadsheet or the scorecard will calculate your score. At the end of each round, we're going to announce those correct answers, and then at the end of the entire quiz, we're going to ask for you all to post your winning score, and then we will see if we can find who the TMF genius is throughout today's session. So just to talk a little bit about some of the rounds today. So round one is regulatory riddles. So it's everything to do with regulation, standards. Round two is inspection interrogation. So this is all about inspections. Trial Master File Family Feud is round three. So this is going to be the round, there are going to be questions in a family feud style. So these are all of the questions center around what our audience has been surveyed. So you'll have to guess what you think the most popular answer is with the audience. Round four is TMF Health and Metrics. And then round five is a Jeopardy style round. where we will tell you the answer and you have to guess the question. Makes sense to you, Rob? Ready to kick it off?
All good this side. And it's nice to see the chat is going well, but make sure it doesn't go too rowdy. If it is, we're going to have to boot you out, buy you out of the pub. So, you know, keep it a bit tame. A bit of a drinking game. Make sure that every time either me or Oliver say, you're on mute, that's a good chance for a swig. So, yeah, let's get into it.
Let's get into it. All right. Cheers, Rob. Thanks for that. So let's do Regulus B. Riddle. So question number one, which section under the ICH efficacy heading serves as the guideline for GCP? Is it option one or answer one, E4? Is it number two, E5? Is it number three, E6? Or number four, E7? We'll give everybody a few minutes to answer that question, or I guess a few seconds. And we'll allow everyone to answer. You're going to be monitoring the chat there, Rob, so let me know if anybody's having issues.
I will do. I will be keeping an eye out on things, taking any orders in case anything comes in.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, I'll take a couple swigs while we're waiting. Amazing. With my Montrim glass, no less. All right, moving on to the next question. Always on brand. Which newly enacted regulation provides a binding set of rules governing the conduct of clinical trials for all EU member states? Is it number one, 536/2021? Is it number two, 534/2014? Is it number three, 534/2021? Or is it number four, 536/2014? Again, we'll give everybody a chance to make sure that they're capturing the different things that they want to capture in their scorecard. What's the chat saying, Rob? Is there any commentary that we should be aware of?
There's a lot of people incredibly excited about the fact that there's some good sound effects. And the rest of it, I think, is people justifying the fact that they can now drink some beer.
So, there we go. Good. That's what we need. All right, moving on. Digital signatures must be compliant with which FDA regulation? Is it option one, 21 CFR part 80? Is it number two, 21 CFR part 11? Is it number three, 21 CFR part 80? 22 CFR part 80? Or is it number four, 21 CFR part 12? Again, make sure that you're capturing the answer. The easiest way in your digital scorecard is just to put one, two, three, or four. No need to write the full answer as we go through this. So one, two, three, four, and some have five options. And when we go through the end of this round, we'll go through the answers. Question number four or five, I'm not sure what question it is now. Which regulatory agency requires you to maintain a TMF for 25 years? Seems like a trick question, I think. Number one, the MHRA. Number two, Health Canada. Number three, EMA. Or number four, FDA. So remember, make sure you put your answers in your digital scorecard. We'll give everybody a few seconds to answer.
And I am calling out live that if Harriet, who is in my marketing team, gets this wrong, seeing as we are an archiving company, then there's going to be hell to pay.
There you go. Harriet's been called.
Harriet, this one, it needs to be right. Needs to be right, Harriet.
Amazing. I see that Carol here says, where can we get some TMF swag? You can get some TMF swag by completing the contest. We have a contest running right now. The last chance is later on today. At TMF, you can put a picture of TMF we've set up. So you can go there. All right, moving on. Which regulatory agency released a guideline in June 2021 covering the use of computerized systems and electronic data in clinical trials? which regulatory agency released a guideline in June 2021 covering the use of computerized systems and electronic data in clinical trials? Is it one, the FDA, two, MHRA, three, EMA, or four, Health Canada? Yeah, no answering in the chat, guys. I see a couple of people trying to answer in the chat here. No leading.
Yeah, it's obviously strategic. People are just putting the wrong answer in. Yeah, it's this one, guys. Obviously this one.
Okay. Hey. Next round. If anybody can guess what TV show that's from, throw it into the chat. I just want to see if there's any fans. So the next round is inspection interrogation. This is going to be all on inspections, on inspection readiness. So let's make sure that you're listening and following. I love it, Fran. Okay, moving on. The inspector sees you've received a 483 and asks how many business days you have responded. But you tell them, is it one? Tell them 7 days. Two, 15 days. Three, 30 days. Or four, 60 days. So the inspector says you received a 483. How many business days do you have to respond? Give everybody a few seconds while I take a sip. Special shout out to Molly, who's frantically texting me and letting me know when my slides are up.
Someone on the inside.
That's it. We're our inside man. This is an inspection interrogation, after all.
It is. Anything could happen.
Anything could happen. All right. Looks like everybody got the Law and Order theme tune, so bravo for that. Well done. I'm not sure what SVU means. You know what SVU means? Law and Order, SVU? Maybe I'm being dumb. I don't know. All right, moving on. The inspector sees you're preparing your documents for an upcoming inspection and asks which documents you'll be providing access to. You tell them only site documents, facilities and records, only CRO documents, facilities and records. Number three, all documents and records from the trial, or four, all documents, facilities and records relevant to the trial. Okay, special victims unit. That's the SVU. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, so let's make sure that I see a couple people still trying to answer in the chat. If you haven't already and you've joined us late, scroll down from the screen. You will see an Excel spreadsheet, which is your digital scorecard for today. So you can fill out the answers in that digital score sheet. Moving on. The inspector sees that you're using an ETMF system for your next inspection, great choice, and asks how long you think you should spend training new inspectors in the software. You them less than an hour, less than two, or between 2 and 4 hours, between 5 and 7 hours, or 8+ hours. So is it option one hour, less than an hour, option two, 2 to 4 hours, option three, 5 to 7 hours, option four, +8 hours. These are tough questions. Shout out to Molly for putting these questions together. Very, very good. The inspector.
Very good ones.
There they are. Moving on, next question. The inspector asks you how you're guaranteeing the integrity and accuracy of the data you're collecting before inspection. You tell them that you're using the Alcoa Plus principles, the YMCA Plus principles, the ABCDE Plus principles, obviously. Your brain, because you know you've done everything correctly.
I'm sure I saw something somewhere this week that said if it wasn't written down, it didn't happen. And I'm sure just saying your brain isn't enough. But
there might be a t-shirt with something like that written on it, I think. If there
is, I think I saw one or two.
Exactly. All right. The inspector knows that your sponsor company is working with a CRO and asks who the ultimate responsibility of the TMF falls upon in the event of findings. You tell him or her, or they, Number one, the CRO. Number two, the sites. Number three, the sponsor. Or number four, both the CRO and the sponsor. Again, please make sure that you download the digital scorecard that is found below. Thank you. All right. Is this the last question, Rob, in this round? Can you tell me?
It is. It is the last question for this round.
Okay. So let's go back to the beginning of regulatory riddles. And so we're going to go back and do the scores, because I forgot to do regulatory riddles at the end of the regulatory riddle scores and for the round two. So round one, the answer for which section under the ICH efficacy heading serves as a guideline for GCP? The answer is, Rob?
The answer is number three, E6.
Number three, E6. So make sure that you write that down. If you got that answer correct, make sure you note it down in your scorecard. And when you're noting a correct answer, below your answer, you just indicate one. So if you indicate a one, that will give you 1 point. If you got the answer wrong, just leave it blank. Okay. Number two, Rob, what's the answer to which newly enacted regulation provides a binding set of rules governing the conduct of clinical trials in the EU?
That one was number four, the 536/2014. Better late than never, hey?
That's it. Better late than never. We're there. and it's live. Right, moving on. The question number three. Digital signatures must be compliant with FDA regulation. What regulation should they be compliant with?
So this, everyone should know this one. This is answer two, 21 CFR part 11.
21 CFR part 11. I feel like I have that like tattooed somewhere. I feel like we should all have it tattooed somewhere.
It's I'm surprised people don't just say it in their sleep. It's just something we all say. Yeah.
All right, moving on. If for the question, which regulatory agency requires you to maintain TMF for 25 years? This is a controversial question. What's the answer, Rob?
So the answer down here is answer three, the EMA.
And Health Canada was doing 25 years, but they recently
changed. And MHRA are currently under discussions about how long that they say you should keep it as well. So
the correct answer is EMA.
That is the correct answer, yes. Number three.
All right, moving on. Which regulatory agency released a guideline in June 2021 covering CSV or computer systems and electronic data in clinical trials? What was our answer?
Again, number three, EMA.
Option three, EMA. Those busy folks at the EMA.
Yeah.
Right,
never rest.
So now I want you, your digital scorecard, to go down to the inspection interrogation section or inspector's choice. The inspector sees you've received the 483 and how many business days you have to respond to it.
So that one would be option two, 15 days.
15 business days. Doesn't seem like enough to me, Rob. I don't know about you. 15 days is similar.
It's going to be a long 15 days. That's all I can say.
and it was sweaty and yeah, anxiety provoking 15 days. All right, let's move on. For the question, the inspector sees you preparing your documents for an upcoming inspection and asks which documents you'll be providing access to. You tell them what, Rob?
So you tell them that it will be answer four, all documents, facilities, and records relevant to the trial.
Number four. All right. Harriet Clark. Harriet is surprised at the 15 days. With a question mark and an exclamation mark there. Surprised. All right, moving on. This is question four, I think, of inspection interrogation, if I'm counting correctly. Yep. The inspector sees that you're using an ETMF system for your next inspection, high five, and asks how long you think you should spend training the new inspectors in the software. How long should What's the recommendation for inspector training, Will?
So our good friends over at the EMA say less than an hour. So this isn't something that, you know, should be taking a full day to do. Less than an hour, nice and simple. Get them going.
All right. And last question of this round for the answers. The inspector asks you how you're guaranteeing the integrity and accuracy of the data you're collecting before inspection. You tell them that you're using, I hope it's YMCA.
It's not. It is Alcoa Plus this time. It's Alcoa Plus. And we've actually got one more. Apologies. That was me not counting. We've got one more after this. There's one more question.
So this is question four, if anybody's wondering.
Yes.
Perfect. The inspector learns that your sponsor company is working with a CRO and asks who the ultimate responsibility of the TMF falls upon in the event of findings. You tell them. I wanted, just a caveat, I wanted to have an option here for the vendor. So I think that would have been a funnier answer, but that got vetoed. So what's the answer, Rob?
So the answer is the sponsor, but I'm with you. The vendor would have been a fun answer.
Yeah.
So, on this one, it is answer number three, the sponsor.
All right. So this is the last question in this round, right?
Yes, that is it. We are done on the two rounds. They were the shorter of the rounds, but hopefully everyone still had fun and is ready and raring to go for the new ones.
All right, so we've got one more round and I'm going to hand it over to our lad Rob and he's going to take the rest of the questions. The next round is Family Feud Drama of Style. Oh, that's enough of that. So the way that this round works, if any of you have watched Family Feud, if you haven't, it's phenomenal. I think I would recommend you all do so. But if you haven't, I'll explain the rules. So this round is designed based on an audience that we've surveyed or data that we've got from survey results. And so you want to be not necessarily picking the right answer or the answer that you would pick, but you want to try and pick the answer that you think everybody picked, the most popular answer, okay? So bear that in mind as we go through this quiz round. This round is 10 questions. It's round number three, and it's the Trial-Massifal Family Feud, okay? And again, just as a reminder, you need to make sure that you're filling out your digital scorecard. So please don't post the answers. If you're coming here a little late, please don't pass the answers in the general chat. Do so in your scorecard. If you can't find it, scroll down and it is right there.
I will keep Paul, an eye out. It's Family Fortunes in the UK. That's right. I was just going to say, if I see any of the answers, I will, because I have the power, I will look at deleting a few of them. So I will look at deleting them. Yeah, I tell you what, I've got this stick and I'm not afraid to use it. That's all I can say.
It's funny, the more we go on, the more I do see a shepherd in you with that stick. Anyway, moving on. Question number one in round three, which is Family Feud. Rob, please keep me honest on the number of questions that we've done. So question number one, which of the following do you think is the most difficult TMF metric to track? Is it one? Does our survey think that quality is the most difficult metric to track? Do they think that completeness is the most difficult metric to track, or do they think timeliness is the most difficult metric to track? So we'll give everybody a few seconds there. Should be a pretty simple one here. I know what I would pick.
So again, what you're trying to do is pick for the one that most people selected.
Exactly, the most popular.
It's not always about what you think, it's about what the collective is going to think.
There is. All right, moving on. Question number two, how often do you conduct periodic reviews? So how often do you conduct periodic reviews? And so again, we're trying to make sure that we understand how the audience has voted. What do we think the audience or the vast majority of people that were surveyed to this question voted? Is it one at every milestone? Is it two, monthly or quarterly, or is it three at the end of the study? All right, Rob, I see you deleting comments there. This is great.
Tell you, I'm going to go crazy with all this power.
All right, moving on. Question number three, I think. Which next generation feature would be at the top of your ETMF bucket list? So what do we think people think is it, you know, what do we think that people want at the top of their bucket list? Is it an online data collection and forms? Sounds pretty boring. Is it number two, logical health checks? Or is it three, truly accurate completeness? What do we think is the most voted answer from our survey? All right, moving on. What is the most important quality metric to track in your TMF? What is the most important quality metric to track in your TMF? Does our survey say that the most popular answer is rejection by site or stakeholder, the reason for rejection, document rejection rate in general, or all of the above? Okay, or is it all of the above? Question number five?
Number five.
Yeah, is it five?
Yeah. It's when halfway, Mark.
There we are, halfway. When do you think when do you think inspection readiness should begin? So when do you, like, what's the survey saying here? Do we think that people think that the inspection readiness should start on day one upon notification of an inspection or upon regulatory application submission? This one's an easy one, I hope.
It's number four, it's after you've already got submission.
There it is, yeah. It's once the product's on the market.
Yeah.
All right, moving on. Which aspect of TMF management would you like to see more resources for, more available resources, tools, educational resources? Does our survey say TMF metrics, TMF audits and inspections, TMF migration, or other? Which aspect of TMF management would you like to see more resources for? Does our survey say TMF metrics, TMF audits and inspections, TMF migration, or other? Moving on. What benchmark does your organization use for timely filing of documentation in the TMF? What benchmark does your organization use for timely filing of documentation in the TMF? Was our most popular answer 7 days or less from creation, 30 days or less from creation, 3 months or less from creation, or other? I see some comments coming here. This was a general survey to all TMF and clinical operations professionals. So if you're wondering who we surveyed, we didn't just rock up at Walmart and start asking people about TMF. This was somewhat of a relevant audience.
Yeah, half of the answers would be, what does TMF stand for?
Right, exactly. We wouldn't get the answer, we get guess. All right, moving forward. How do you currently, I think this is a typo. How do you currently archive content and metadata? How do you currently archive TMF content and metadata? Does our survey say, the most popular answer is we use our ETMF native archive function. We are not currently archiving TMF content. Seems strange. We have developed our own archive function or something else, other. All right, moving forward. What question am I on, Rob? Keep me honest.
So this will be number nine.
Number nine. Okay, we're almost done with this round.
Penultimate
question. Which of the following TMF exchange solution types do you partially or fully support? So again, this is a survey. So does our survey say TMF integration, archiving, batch indexing, or other? So is it option one, TMF integration? Is it option two, archiving? Or is it option three, migration? Or option four, other, sorry. Moving on, final question of the round before we go back and do answers. how are final transfers of the ETMF from CRO to sponsor currently performed? Again, this was a question that was asked to TMF community. What do we think is the most common answer? Is it number one, the CRO enters content manually into the sponsor's ETMF? Content is automatically transferred by integration between CRO and sponsor. Hope that's the answer. CRO sends content by file transfer and enters content manually into TMF or some other method, some other way. So we'll give everybody a few seconds while we rifle back to the first question, and then we'll go through the answers. We'll give everybody a few seconds.
Yeah, we've even got the percentage that voted for this, so you can judge your fellow peers.
There you go. We can judge. All right. Answer to question number one of this round. So make sure you've got your, you're ready to take what the correct answer is and mark what you, if you answer correctly or not. Answer to question one. Which of the following do you think is the most difficult TMF metric to track? What's the answer, Rob? What did our survey say?
Our survey says, answer number one, quality, with 43% of the vote.
43% of survey respondents said that quality was the most difficult metric to track. Love that. Question number two, how often do you conduct periodic reviews? What does our survey say?
Survey says, answer number two, monthly or quarterly, and 63% voted for this one.
63%. Monthly or quarterly. Question number three, the answer. Which next generation feature would be at the top of your ETMF bucket list? Our survey says.
Answer number three, the truly accurate completeness, and 69% voted for this one.
Wow, almost 70% are looking for truly accurate completeness. Question number four. What is the most important quality metric to track in your ETMF? Our survey says.
Survey went straight in for the all of the above. Answer number four.
All of the above.
All of the above. It feels like a cop-out. It does a little bit, doesn't it?
All right. Question number five. When do you think inspection readiness should begin? Our survey says.
Answer number one, on day one. And 85% voted for this. I want to know what the other 15% voted for. And I want to know if anyone voted for that upon the regulatory application submission.
I hope they did, just for fun.
Yeah.
All right, question number six. Which aspect of TMF management would you like to see more resources for? Our survey says.
Answer number two, TMF audits and inspections. 42% voted for that.
Not surprised. All right, moving forward. Question number
seven. This one is seven.
Question number seven. Note to self for next year, we should totally put question numbers on these slides.
Yeah.
What benchmark does your organization use for timely filing of documentation in the TMF? Our survey says.
Answer number two, 30 days or less from creation, and that was 73% voted for that.
Yeah, there were. I remember this. This was a poll that we did on our LinkedIn page, and I remember that there was a decent percentage of people that did 7 days or less from creation. So kudos to you guys there.
That is very, very on the ball.
All right, moving forward. Question number, I've forgotten already.
Number eight.
Perfect. How do you currently do TMF archiving and how do you currently archive TMF content and metadata? Our survey says.
Answer number three, we have developed our own archive function and 40.6% voted for this one.
That must be good news for you, you and your archive room friends.
It is. I'm sure Harriet is writing this one down as we speak.
All right, perfect. Question number nine.
Yep.
Which of the following TMF exchange solution types do you partially or fully support? Our survey says.
Answer number one, TMF integrations, with 69.7% of the vote.
Look at that. TMF integration. Good for you guys. And then our final question for the round, how are final transfers of the TMF from CRO to sponsor currently performed? Our survey says.
Service says, answer number three, CRO sends content by file transfer and sponsor enters content manually into the TMF, 52.5%.
Wow, we've got to change that.
Yes, we do.
All right, moving on. Rob, TMF Alpha Metric.
There we go.
I was hoping that would go a little longer.
It didn't. Get a bit of a pump on.
That's it. Rob, hand it over to you.
Perfect. So let's start off with question number one. So TMF health is usually considered when you achieve these three things. Number one, readiness, right first time and real time. Number two, timeliness, quality and completeness. Or number three, on time, quality, and continuous. So when do you think that TMF health is usually considered that you've achieved it?
I like number three. I don't know about you. Number three looks good to me.
I'll go for that one. Yeah, it's on time.
Ready to move on?
Yeah, let's go for it.
Question number two. See, look, we've got question numbers here. This is perfect.
I know, this one's going to be nice. So, question number two, technology is all that is needed to achieve TMF health. True or false? So, a nice simple one. Number one for true, number two for false. It's all you need is just a bit of technology and you're all good to go.
I think so. Sounds good to me. But maybe I'm biased.
What else do you need? Slap a bit of technology in, AI, machine learning, it'll do it all for us. That's it.
Yeah, exactly. We don't need human beings anymore. Let's move on. Question number three.
So what is the difference between KPQs and KPIs? So number one, the last letter. Really simple. Number two, key performance questions are the things that the key performance indicators should answer using the metrics. And number three, key primary quality is the overall quality of the TMF, whereas key people identifier are used simply to highlight who owns the KPQ.
Yeah. And these are long answers. So if you're looking to blame anyone, blame Rob.
Yeah. I didn't even think about this and the fact that I'd have to read them out. So I was there happily writing away. And then I thought, oh, no, I have to read all these out now.
Rob's written a novel in the questions here. All right, we'll move on. Question number four.
So, good metrics should be smart. But what does SMART stand for? Specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. Specific, measurable, accountable, real-time, and technical. And number three, specific, maintainable, achievable, reproducible, and time-bound. So what does SMART stand for?
I like real-time metrics. I don't know about you, Rob.
There's no other time that can be used. It has to be real-time.
Don't listen to me, guys. If you think I'm leading you in the wrong way. All right, question number five. We're halfway through the TMF Health for Metrics round. What we got, Rob?
So, see, this is a nice little answer one. So, which metric measures the total number of final documents out of the total number of expected documents? Is it one, quality, two, timeliness, three, completeness, or four, rejection rate? So, it's which metric measures the total number of final documents out of the total number of expected documents?
All right, moving on. Question number six.
So carrying on in that vein, which metric is constituted by the percentage of documents reviewed and the rejection rate of the reviewed documents? Is it number one, quality? Number two, timeliness? Number three, completeness? Or number four, net promoter score?
These are tough questions.
I didn't want it to be easy. you need to earn these points.
That's it. That's the point of this whole trivia, is did you learn enough at TMF week this week? Exactly. So if you don't know the answer to this question,
You've got to reread and rewatch everything again. It's the only way.
There you go. Question number seven, which metric is calculated by percentage of filed on time equals the final artifact date minus artifact creation date and the expected days to filing or the total final artifact? Again, this is a wrong question. Is it number one, quality? Number two, timeliness? Number three, completeness? Or number four, net promoter score? These are tough, Rob. You're really testing the team here.
Well, I was told that, you know, TMF week was full of TMF experts. So I thought the last thing they need is simple ones. They're going to want, you know, something to really get them going.
All right. Let's hope the easier ones next.
Okay. So question number eight. Let's move on to that one.
Do you see my screen?
It hasn't refreshed to number eight yet. There we go. We're there. So, which of the following are crucial areas supported by implementing TMF metric programs? So, number one, compliance with TMF processes, TMF expectations, contracts and service level agreements. Number two, tracking health to verify trends and to be able to perform continuous improvements. Number three, planning of future studies, timelines and resource requirements. Number four, performance of CRO, industry standards and internal functional lines. On number five, just all of them. So which of the following are crucial areas supported by implementing these TMF metrics?
Because the answers are a little longer on this one, we'll keep it up for a few more seconds than usual. There are five answers. So is it compliance with TMF processes, expectations, contracts and SLAs? Is it number two, tracking health to verify trends and be able to perform continuous improvement? Is it three, planning for future studies? Is it number four, the performance of the CRO over industry standards and internal functional lines? Or is it number five, all of the above? All right, moving on. Penultimate question of this round before we go back and look at the answers. Rob, take it away.
So your overall TMF can only ever be as healthy as the documents within it. For that reason, clinical documents need to meet Alcoa criteria. But what is Alcoa? So is it number one, accountable, legible, contemporaneously? I can't even say that one. It's too late.
Contemporary. Or
accurate. There we go. You can do it when we get to the next one. Number two, attributable, legible, current, original, and accurate. Or number three, attributable, legible,
contemporaneous,
original, and accurate.
There you go, teamwork.
There we are.
We'll give everybody a couple seconds. What is Alcoa, basically, guys? So give us what the acronym actually means. Obviously, there's plus, 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 all the other pluses that are coming on, but we're just looking for what is Alcoa. All right, last question around before we do answers, and then we'll move on to our final round. Question number 10, Rob.
So anyone who has been reading the stuff on the monitoring website, which should be everybody, because it's some very, very good information up there. So monitoring details six benefits of using TMF metrics. Which of these are not mentioned? Number one, it develops a common language through data. Number two, it improves inspection readiness. Number three, it supports you in planning and realizing an effective strategy. Or number four, it can help eliminate wasted spend and resource.
This is tough. This is genuinely a tough question.
I think I'm most proud of this one. This was definitely one that I was looking through the Montreal website and went, this would be a good one. And this is also a good one for you, Oliver, to see which of your team have actually been looking and reading the stuff that you promote.
I know that everyone on our team always reads a lot of content.
Yeah, so that'll be 100%. They haven't got anything to worry about.
All right, so we're going to go back. Everybody, a few more seconds to answer this question in their scorecard. A reminder, if you haven't got it already, round four, make sure that you are answering in your digital scorecard. Let's go back to question one to go through the answers. So, Rob, take us away with the answers for question number one. TMF health is usually considered when you achieve these three things.
And the answer for that one is number two, timeliness, quality, and completeness.
Love it. The three pillars. Question number two, the answer to question number two, technology is all that is needed to achieve TMF health. Is that true or false, Rob?
That is false. So answer number two for that one.
Don't believe you.
What is also needed is a really good vendor. That's what I've heard.
There you go. All right. Question number three. What is the difference between KPQs and KPIs? I'm interested in this answer. The answer wrong.
So answer number two, key performance questions are the things that the key performance indicators should answer using the metrics. So answer number two.
So KPQs are what KPIs should answer.
That's the one.
Question number four, the answer for good metrics should be SMART. What does SMART stand for?
So it is answer number one, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound.
So Fran, so, at this point, everybody knows Fran from TMF. But Fran thinks that SMART stands for smarmy, massive, aching, ridiculous, and technology, which I think is much better than specific, measurable.
Yeah, I mean, that's... When I'm looking for metrics, I always want to make sure they're smarmy. That's exactly. Definitely up there.
And who doesn't love massive metrics, right?
Absolutely. The bigger the better.
Who do we need to write to get this this changed? All right. The answer to question number four, which metric measures the total number of final docs out of the total number of expected documents? I think it's completeness.
That is number three, completeness.
Amazing. When you've been here a decade. Question number six. Which metric is constituted by the percentage of documents reviewed and the rejection rate of reviewed documents?
So that is answer number one, quality.
Quality. Hopefully everyone got that one right. All right, moving forward. Question number seven, which metric is calculated by the percentage of filed on time equals the final artifact minus the artifact creation date? Under the expected days filing over the total number of final artifacts. Honestly, I'm confused just reading that, Rob. I have no idea what the answer is.
Well, there's only one pillar left, and it is timeliness, number two.
Timeliness. So you put a hard question, but an obvious answer.
That's how I did it.
Very kind. Fran is asking, what is Net Promoter Score? Net Promoter Score, it's a random metric to track customer happiness. So there you go. Net promotion.
Maybe that's what we should start doing there. Just record TMF happiness.
TMF
that
happiness.
That should be the only metric that's required. TMF happiness.
There you go. I like that. Question number eight. Which of the following are crucial areas supported by implementing TMF metric programs? The answer is?
All of the above. So all of these are crucial areas that implementing TMF metrics can really help with.
Love it. Question number nine. Your overall TMF can only be as healthy as the documents within it. For that reason, clinical documents need to meet Alcoa. What is Alcoa? And again, Fran gave us her own definition, but I'll allow you to give us the right answer.
So, although I do completely agree with Fran, the answer here is number three. So number three there.
So for those of you that didn't see Fran's comment in the chat, Alcoa for Fran stands for always looking cute or awesome, which is genius. I hope, Fran, you came up with that. Last question of this round before we head into the penultimate round, or to the last round, I should say. Monitoring details, six benefits of using TMF metrics. Which of these are not mentioned? Obviously, everyone on the monitoring team got this question right. Rob, what's the answer?
So the answer is number four. It can help eliminate waste, spend, and resource.
So that wasn't a benefit that we'd mentioned in our article, basically.
It was not. But it's an incredibly good thing and worth looking at.
Last orders. We are in a pub quiz after all. Last orders. This is our last quiz round. And then we will bid farewell to you all for a beautiful TMF week. Let's move on to the final round, which is...
This is
I do feel like I need one of them really long, skinny mics.
We should be doing tricks with the mic.
Absolutely.
All right, moving on. Rob, so just to explain this round to everybody, so for those of you that are not Jeopardy fans or have watched Jeopardy in the past, we are going to say the answer and you guys are going to select what the question is. So the answer here is the TMF reference model recently partnered with this global consortium. Is the question, what is ICH? What is MAGI? Was it three? What is CDISC? So the answer is the TMF reference model recently partnered with this global consortium. Number one is the question, what is ICH? Is it what is MAGI or what is CDISC? And as a reminder, please don't put the answer in the chat. You have a digital scorecard. Question number two of the last round. This standard is designed to improve the transfer of ETMF between systems and owners. Is the question, what is the exchange mechanism standard? What is the exchange migration standard? Or is the question, what is the data transfer standard? All right, question number three. The TMF reference model project originated in the DIA document and records management community. Is the question, what is 2006? What is 2007? What is 2008? Or what is 2009?
It's scary looking back at these and sort of thinking about how long ago that was.
Yeah, exactly. Rob, do you want to kick off on the next question?
Yeah, absolutely. So the FDA document required to be completed by the site and filed into the TMF to show the sponsor the investigator's qualifications. What is the FDA 1571? What is the FDA 1572? What is the FDA 3454? Or what is the FDA 3455?
Tough question. All right, moving forward, take it away, Rob.
Okay, so this will be a good one. I counted these myself. The total number of recommended sub artifacts as per the TMF reference model 3.2.1. What is 606? What is 597? What is 827? Or what is 478? So the
clearly
total number of
recommended time on your hands to be able to count all these documents.
Well, I wanted to really, really get people thinking for this last one.
This is a tough one. I don't know the answer to this one. All right, moving on. What question are we on, Rob?
So this will be question number, let's have a look, six, I believe. So the name of artifact 060106, as per 321 of the TMF reference model, what is IP relabeling documentation? What is IP supply plan? What is IP transfer documentation? So how many people
know
their artifacts?
You've got to be a TMF reference model nut for this.
Oh yeah, I mean this is what is gonna really separate the weak from those who deserve the crown of TMF.
The true TMF nerds in the community. All right, moving on.
So this body is not a member of the ICH Association. So not a member of the ICH Association. Number one, FDA, USA. Number two, Health Canada, Canada. Number three, TITCK, Turkey. Or number four, TGA, Australia.
All right, we'll give everybody a few seconds to answer. I love all of the GIFs and the memes. This is absolutely amazing. All right, moving
forward. That's how everything should be. Okay, so the length of time Health Canada now require, so if you've been listening to earlier questions, Health Canada now require you to retain clinical trial records for drugs and natural health products. What is 25 years? What is 20 years? And what is 15 years? So it's the length of time Health Canada now require you to retain clinical trial records for drugs and natural health products.
Let's hope people were listening to our commentary earlier on.
It is. Only people really taking note.
All right, what question are we on, Rob? This is 9, I think.
This is number 9. So the 20th of May, which is today's day, celebrates this day. What is International Clinical Trials Day? What is Yorkshire Day? What is Nurses Day? And what is Patient Safety Day?
Is it, as a Yorkshire lad, is there an actual Yorkshire Day?
Of course there is.
Okay.
Of course there's an actual Yorkshire Day.
Is everybody just
what sort of question is that?
What happens on Yorkshire Day?
You eat Yorkshire puddings. That's a given. and then yeah, you just fly the Yorkshire flag and maybe watch a little bit of Breast Off and all the classic Yorkshire things.
All right, nice. Last question of the round before we go through the answers. Rob, take it away.
So this is the toughest out of the entire set that we've asked. This is often described as the most informative and fun week of the year. And it is, what is TMF week 2022? What is a family trip to Disney World? Or what is an all expense paid shopping trip to New York? So
they all sound pretty fun, to be honest.
They are. I told you it's the toughest one yet.
All right, so let's go through and do the questions real quick because I know that we're almost at time. Let's go back to the first question. So what's the answer? What's the model? What's the global consortium that the TMF reference model is partnered with?
What is CDISC? So what answer number is... 3.
Okay. Question number 2. Standard designed to improve the transfer of ETMF between systems and owners is number 1. ETMF exchange.
Number 1. Standard. Absolutely, obviously.
All right. Perfect. Question number 3, the TMF reference model project originated in the DIA document and records management community in what year?
Answer number 3, what is 2008?
2008, what a big year. All right. Yeah, question number 4, the FDA document required to be completed by the site filed into the TMF to show the sponsor the investigator qualification. Number 1. What is 1571? Number 2, what is 1572? Not what is FDA 3454? What is FDA 3455? What's the answer, Rob?
And that is answer number 2. What is the FDA 1572?
Love it.
Classic.
All right,
document.
Question number 6.
Question number 5. Question number 5 here.
Okay, total number of sub-artifacts. How many?
So that is 606, number 1. So what is 606?
All right. The name of the artifact, 060106.
And that is answer number three. What is IP transfer documentation? As we said, the real nerds are coming out here.
Real nerds. This body is not a member of ICH.
So this one was a dirty one. This one is answer number four, TGA Australia. They are an observer of ICH, but not a member.
Wow.
It was a dirty question.
Question number seven.
Number eight. Yep. So that one is.
Yeah, go ahead.
Answer number three, what is 15 years? So as of earlier this year, Health Canada has reduced the amount of time you need to retain those documents for 15 years.
Those Canadians, eh?
I don't know.
The 20th of May celebrates the International Clinical Trials Day.
Yes, anyone who has been on LinkedIn today especially will know this. And I saw a lot of Yorkshire Day popping up. That is the 1st of August. So make sure it's in your calendar now. The 1st of August is Yorkshire Day.
Amazing. And the last question, if you didn't put TMF week, you're not welcome.
If you didn't put TMF week, you got it wrong. Because the answer is obviously number one, it is what is TMF week. Although, Nicole, I did like the is Disney all expenses paid as well. I mean, that could maybe tip it. Imagine doing TMF week at Disney World.
I'll be honest with you. As much as I love TMF week, I would probably rather go to an all expense paid trip to New York. but that's just me. I'll just watch the recordings afterwards. All right, guys. That brings us to a close for today's quiz. If you guys want to tally up and throw your answers in the chat, and we will see who the winner is. And we'll see who had the highest score.
Keep an eye out for this.
Yeah, we'll try and keep an eye out. I'm going to stop sharing my screen.
I want to know if anyone knew that there were 606 recommended sub artifacts.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say that there's a few here that do.
Did they know or did they guess, though? That's the question.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. That's true. All right. So we've got some 30s, high 30s. Harriet Clark, 37. Harriet, you're cheating. I know you're cheating. We've got Harriet, top score so far.
Carol's up there as well with 37.
Carol's at 37. Joint lead. All right. Look at that, 33. Let's see what everyone else got.
Of course, Paul knew. Paul knew. Paul's really got it written down somewhere.
That's it. All right, I think. Fran, let's add 60 artifacts. I like that. Let's do 60 sub artifacts, 666. So I'm going to crown two winners, Carol and Harriet. So Carol and Harriet, congratulations for being TMF geniuses and winning today's quiz. I want to thank everybody for turning up. I hope everybody had fun. Rob, thank you so much for joining me on this journey.
It was a pleasure.
Fun time. I will I'll close today's session and, more importantly, close today's TMF week. Although if you do want to continue networking, you can head over to the lounge. They will be open for the rest of today. But with that, I will stop the stream and thank you all so much. Thanks, everyone. Thanks
very much, Montrium. Cheers. Bye.